position on this, Claire?
Golson, it is a big story today. President Obama canceling his meeting next month with Russian President Vladimir Putin. This comes after Russia granted temporary asylum to NSA leaker Edward Snowden. Congressman McClintock calls the president's decision, quote, silly, and he says the U.S. should grant amnesty to Snowden.
I think it would be best if the American government granted him amnesty to get him back to America where he can answer questions without the threat of prosecution. We have some very good laws against sharing secrets, and he broke those laws. On the other hand, he broke them for a very good reason, because those laws were being used in direct contravention of our Fourth Amendment rights as Americans.
Representative McClintock also had choice words about the Affordable Care Act and why he believes the government should not fund it.
There's nothing affordable about it. It turns out that was a lie. It sent our insurance costs through the roof. We were also lied to when we were told, if you like your plan, you can keep it. We were also lied to when we were told it was good for the economy. It's, according to the Congressional Budget Office, creating a net loss of about 800,000 jobs.
And finally, I asked him about this Congress being called a do-nothing Congress. Their approval rating hit a low of 15%.
Congress right now is badly divided because the American people are divided. But I think as they see this self-described train wreck of Obamacare unfold before us, as they watch the continued challenge to our freedoms from indiscriminate searches of Americans' phone records, we have a model of bipartisan cooperation. The problem is the president is not following it.
And we plan to pose similar questions to Democratic Congressman Ami Bera during his upcoming Veterans Summit.